Well, what's going on, everyone? I have an awkward camera angle set up right now because I want to showcase this build here that you just saw us build. This is this build here that you just saw us build. Wow, that really really nailed it there. What's going on, everyone? Wanted to showcase and show off another PC build we put together here in the studio. This is not sponsored by Be Quiet, but it is utilizing many Be Quiet components because we wanted an emphasis on the silent factor with this one. So what I'm going to do in this video is run through the specifications first and then show you what I mean by silence, because this thing is dead quiet. It's actually a really nice PC to edit with, especially if you're going to be filming next to it. You really can't hear anything. I think I hear my personal rig across the room more than I hear this thing. So I'm going to show you what we use to build this PC, the parts in particular. I have those parts, by the way, linked in the video description if you want to build something similar. They are tied to our Amazon and Newegg affiliate account, so we do get a small kickback if you decide to purchase anything through those links. So the first piece to this puzzle is probably the most obvious, and that is the Be Quiet Dark Base 700. This has RGB integration out of the box. You can actually control the RGBs themselves on the case. Actually, up front they have a little toggle switch there. You can also utilize USB Type-C 3.1, which is pretty cool. I talk more about this case in my dedicated review right here, but building in it just gives you like more of an in-depth analysis of the case's layout and how things work and where optimal placements are for certain things like SSD trays and for cutouts with cables. Also out of the box, you'll find a few Be Quiet Silent Wings 3 fans. These are some of the best fans on the market in my book. They are super silent, a bit pricey, but you get what you pay for. Now onto the tech specs. We have first off an i5-8600K, which I'll be reviewing in a dedicated video here shortly. Excellent value in my opinion CPU. You get 6 full-on cores, no multi-threading support, but for under 300 bucks, this is a heck of a gaming CPU for sure. Maybe not the best for content creation, I would still opt for the i7 in that case, but for purely gaming and even some streaming, you could definitely take that on with the 8600K, especially if you want to overclock it to something like 5 gigahertz. The motherboard we're using is the MSI Gaming Pro Carbon. It's a sexy board with RGB support. I've got everything set to yellow right now because this is actually Lisa's build, and she's a big yellow fan, so she's really happy about the support there. We also got the G-Skill Trident Z RGB modules to match the board. They actually sync up perfectly with MSI's Mystic Light software, so it will detect the G-Skill RAM out of the box, like in the software itself, which is really cool. I didn't know that it would do that. And it even detected our Cooler Master keyboard, so now everything is kind of set to like an orange-yellow. There is no specific yellow color support with the case, so we just picked orange, so it's all kind of like an orange-gold-yellow combination, but you get the point. The next thing I want to show off is the Be Quiet Dark Rock TF. The TF stands for top flow, so this is actually a top down flow CPU cooler, and it does have 2 Silent Wings 3 fans built in. So we're literally going full on Silent Wings 3 fans with this build, but that's why it's extremely quiet. You'll see that here shortly. This has an insanely high TDP. It allows for insane overclock, so I think we're at 5.1 gigahertz right now on the 8600K, and temperatures are still staying around 80 degrees Celsius under full load in Ida 64. So very impressed with this, and it does maintain a very quiet profile throughout, which is pretty impressive. Now the next component I want to show off is the EVGA GTX 1070 Ti for the win. This card is a beautiful, sexy card. I've always loved EVGA cards. They sent a 1070 Ti out for review. I decided to put it in this system here, not only because it is fairly powerful for the cache, but it's also very quiet, which fits the theme beautifully. So we're gonna run some benchmarks with this build in particular, because I expect that people spending, I don't know, around 1070, 1070 Ti money for a gaming PC are probably gonna pair it with something like an i5 or maybe a locked i7, or on Ryzen side, maybe Ryzen 5 1600-ish territory. So that's why it's in this build. I'll also be benchmarking, like I said, with this build in particular. Stay tuned for that video, but this card, I can say just right now, is literally silent because the fans are off. That's just how it's designed. And when it gets thrown under load, the fans spool up, they still stay pretty quiet because this cooler is beefy. But a silent build wouldn't be truly silent without a quiet power supply, and that's why we went with a Be Quiet Dark Power Pro 11. I've used this particular unit in the past quite a bit. It's still going strong, and that's why I want to emphasize it in this build. It's not cheap, but again, you get what you pay for. If you want products that last, then you got to pay a bit more for them. Otherwise, buy cheap hardware and keep replacing the things every 1 or 2 years. And a power supply, let me tell you, is not something you want to cheap out on. This unit is semi-modular, but I mean, come on, who's not going to use a 24-pin? And all of the modular cables are, in fact, black-sleeved, which means that they're not going to look hideous in your case. I expect that most modern power supplies will have black sleeves, but still, it's nice to have them in this build because everything is black. Now, you're not seeing them because I decided to use custom sleeve cables from two different companies or two different people. So the 24-pin here and the 8-pin EPS up top were actually made by Primochill, and I just had them laying around from a previous build. I wanted to throw something else in here to spice things up a bit more. And then the two 8-pin cables here, the two 8-pin VGA cables, are from Tony from Virility PC Customs. His YouTube channel is linked in the video description. The guy makes a ton of sweet cables. He's done it for us for several months on the channel, and I just want to give him another shout out and really show off how good these things look. Even in a case that doesn't have any white components, you can find a use for white sleeve cables. Now, it wouldn't make much sense in a build with a silent emphasis to throw in a hard drive because those do have literal spinning components. I mean, think of them like fans, like they're still making noise because they are moving. And that's why we went with a 500 gigabyte Samsung SSD in this build only. You could add a second one, go RAID 0 or RAID 1 if you wanted to get fancy with it, but an SSD is a wise choice in a silent build because there are no moving parts inside. Now, to end all of your suspense, I'm sure most of you clicked on this video to hear how quiet this build actually is. You're like, no, Greg, I bet you it's still pretty loud. And you'll see in a second here, at idle it's virtually silent, and under load it's actually still really quiet, even with the side panel off. But I'll put it on, and I'll put the microphone in the build so that you can hear what happens when the heat kind of builds up in the case, right? Because you have the side panel off, then things are going to be artificially quieter because you're basically cooling off your system or allowing it to have more access to air from the outside. So that build will be compared to, just for kicks, my personal rig, which is a fully custom cooled build. It'd be interesting to see which one is quieter, custom cooled build or just, you know, air cooled build using the quiet components. I do have a D5 pump in there along with a 360mm rad and a 240mm rad. So with that, here are the sound tests. Well, there you have it, folks. Clearly this thing is really quiet. In fact, I was actually surprised by how much of the fluid I could hear in my personal rig moving. I guess I don't really pay attention to it because like water drops and like water moving through pipes and whatnot actually sounds pretty peaceful to me. I just don't realize how loud it actually is. But that and in combination with a D5 pump makes it a louder system than I originally anticipated. Even though I sit next to it literally every day, it's pretty loud, especially in the case. So with that, if you have anything you'd like to add, maybe you want to show off your build, if you have a really quiet build that you want to list the specs of or something along those lines, maybe you're using Noctua or a competing company to keep your PC quiet, I want to hear about all of that in the comments below. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you thought it was cool or interesting. Give it a thumbs down if you feel the complete opposite or if you hate everything about life. Be sure to click the subscribe button if you haven't already and stay tuned for more content like this. This is Science Studio. Thanks for building with us.